Howdy folks, I'm the Roleplay Gamer, but you can call me Dinner. Welcome to MechWarrior Online, what I'm referring to in my little phone fantasy realm as the thinking man's shooter, but I'm not sure if that's necessarily correct. We're going to talk a little bit about it today. If you don't want to hear all the talky explanation stuff, you are more than welcome to head to the description and click the handy little time code link, which will take you straight to the shooty gameplay. Enjoy that. Now, for everyone else, I am a huge mech fan, specifically MechWarrior, the BattleTech Universe. I like my big lumbering walkers rather than my fast Japanese-style mechs. And it really started when I got MechWarrior 2 Mercenaries as part of like a joystick pack thing in my youth. Played the shit out of that game. Didn't understand a single second of it. Wasn't very good at all, but Jesus Christ, I love it. And it's actually taken me a couple tries to get into MechWarrior Online, but I'm finally into it and I'm loving it. It's the first couple times it was kind of daunting. I didn't really understand what was going on. I didn't understand how to play and I was getting killed a lot and I was like, this isn't fun. I don't know what's changed now. I don't think it's the game. It's just my perception has changed and now I understand it, and it's fucking fantastic. It's not that scary, guys. So if you look at this, or if you've tried it before and you've gone, holy shit, I have no idea what I'm doing, I'm gonna try and help you, but just, you know, try and persevere with it, and hopefully eventually you'll understand it and you'll be having as much fun as I am. So this is not your run and gun type of shooter, even when you're playing mechs that are more geared towards that playstyle. And that's one of the best things about this game. You have different weight classes of mechs and they all play differently and you all have different roles based on that. Even then, it's not your sort of let's be a lone hero kind of guy. For the most part, depending on which mech you pick, you want to stay with your group and it's all about supporting your teammates. You don't want to be the hero. So where that differs slightly is with the light mechs, and that's why I like them. I'm playing the light mechs at the moment because I understand them the best, and I'm the best with them, and they're more about scouting. So you want to go out at the beginning of a round of the mission and find where the enemy is. Maybe try to flank them if you want to be bold. That's what I like to do. Sometimes it works really well. Sometimes it doesn't at all. But still, you don't want to get into fights, because even like a light mech against a light mech, then it's down to pilot skill and aim, really, how steady you can keep your torso and whittle them down. And yeah, it can end up really badly, because even like in my experience, best case scenario, when I've won a one-on-one fight with another light mech, I'm pretty badly damaged and can't take any more hits from anything, so I got to be careful for the rest of the round. But if you get ganged up on in a light mech, that's it, you're done. But I love them because they're super fast and they can take down the bigger mechs if you're good at dodging and just staying out of their line of fire and staying behind them as much as possible. You can whittle them down, especially if you've got, you know, you're in a light mech against just one heavy or assault. I've done it before. I've actually gone one-on-one with the big guys and won. And if you can get a little group of lights against some of the big guys, it's game over. It's pretty wild stuff. So it's definitely a more fast-paced, thrilling type of gameplay. But then you got your light mechs, and here we go. I actually haven't, so just as a disclaimer, I'm in no way presenting myself as an authority on this. I'm no way an expert. There's a lot of stuff here that I'm not familiar with and I still have to learn. I haven't even bought a mech yet. I'm just using the trial mechs here just to get a feel of what I want. And I think I'm going to be buying a Raven, because it seems to just be working for me. I like the Raven variant with the two large lasers. That's good fun. So you've got your trial mechs here. You got your light mechs, which I just explained. Your medium mechs, which are probably the biggest mystery to me. They're kind of all rounders. They're not quite as fast as the light mechs, but they have a little bit more armor, a little more firepower. But they still can't take that much of a beating. The impression I get is they're kind of a jack of all trades, fit into whatever role they need to fit into at the time, kind of thing. Maybe as light support for the bigger mechs, so they have that mobility that the big mechs don't, at the expense of armor and firepower. Then you've got your heavy mechs, which are, you know, naturally your heavy hitters, but they're really slow as a result, but they can take a beating, right? So you're probably not going to be ducking and weaving with these guys like you can with the light mechs and sometimes the medium mechs. You're going to want to find a good angle and just press it. And then you've got your assaults. So, and again, I'd like to remind you, this couldn't be entirely wrong. This is just my impression of these weight classes from my time playing the game, which is about... maybe, I think, like 20 hours at this point. 20 hours this time. I have played more previously before I really got into it. The assault mechs, the impression I get from these guys is they're like your catapults. For all intents and purposes, they're like stationary weapons platforms that you can move around, which I know is sort of sounds contradictory. So you find a good position in some cover, and maybe you shoot over the terrain and whatnot with the assistance of light mechs, which can scout for you and spot targets. So just like you would, I don't know, any sort of spotting mechanic for a sniper in even like XCOM. I was thinking like real-time strategy games. Sometimes that they do that. But like XCOM with squad sight. So you think of like the assaults having squad sight, and your light mechs are the spotters. So they go out maybe on their own just to sneakily duck in and out of crevasses and find the enemies. And they will get experience and monetary bonuses for doing so. You don't have to be killing the enemy to do really well in a round. You can still be useful in a support capacity. And assist kills are also very important. So even if you're not getting the last shot on an enemy, just the fact that you've laid in some damage at all counts towards an assist, so you're rewarded for that. It's really great. I'm loving it. The matchmaking system does seem a little bit wonky. There's more to it to get my head around, but basically my understanding of it is whenever you go like a quick play match, which is just your regular anyone can get in matchmaking sort of thing, You've got a team that the system expects to win and a team that the system expects to lose. And if you, I think how it goes is if you win when you're expected to win, you stay where you are. And if you win when you're expected to lose, you go up. But if you lose when you were expected to lose, you stay where you are. And if you lose when you were expected to win, you go down. So it's this weird thing of like the favorite usually wins naturally because they're expected to based on a whole bunch of variables, which you probably have something to do with like kill death ratio of players or something like that. I really don't know. So you've got this weird place where everyone kind of doesn't move that much unless they pull it out of the fire. It's very weird. So the fact that you're losing, and this is partly what stopped me from getting into it the first time, like, Jesus, I'm always losing, I'm just no good at this game. That doesn't necessarily mean you're not good at it and you're not improving. You don't have to be winning matches to be improving as a player. You're still getting experience and being valuable to your team. Again, I don't know that much about this whole system, so I'm not going to put forth an actual opinion, but one of the things that I've read in the forums is someone suggested that the amount of damage you do based on the actual weight of your mech is a good indication of how well you're doing. So if you go for like 2 to 3 times the damage compared to the weight of your mech, then you've had a good round. Now, I did see some people disagreed with that, but it also seems like a nice tidy rule to go by. So based on that and the experience I'm getting at the end of matches, I have actually been doing really well despite the fact that I have lost most matches. And yeah, you can also say that, well, look, if your team doesn't work together, that's certainly a deciding factor as well. And of course, it's harder to work together when you're just randoming with any old jack-off playing MechWarrior like myself. Unless everyone's on VoIP and they're, you know, coordinating and whatnot. And sometimes you look at the spectator mode once you've died and you see the guys in the big mechs and the heavy mechs or the assault mechs. And it's like, dude, you have no idea what you're doing. You just went for like the biggest guns possible because you thought you'd do really well. And it's like he's overheating every 2 seconds and it's just making a mess. So yeah, I mean, if you expect to have like really good games just getting into the like the quick play, you might not have a lot of fun. But if you're just concerned about doing as well as you possibly can, which is what I'm doing at the moment, yeah, you might be able to get some enjoyment out of this. And I've just gone off on this big old tangent. But yeah, there's a lot here. So there's also mech customization and whatnot, which I won't get into because I haven't done a lot of it. Like I said, this is just a trial mech because I've certainly got enough credits here, or C-bills, do they call them? Comstar bills. C-bills, right? Yeah, so you've got premium currency and C-bills. You don't need premium currency to buy mechs. It's mostly for special mechs that, as far as I understand, are more like nostalgia and cosmetic-based, not necessarily more powerful. And otherwise, it's for cosmetic changes. Such as changing the color scheme of your mech and whatnot. But most of the mechs, the vast majority of the mechs, are purchasable with in-game currency. And I do have enough to buy actually quite a few mechs at the moment. So I could probably fill out my mech bays, but I haven't yet because I want to be absolutely sure what I want to get, you know? I think I will be getting the Raven. I've been having a lot of success with it so far. It's a very sexual looking mech. I like my mechs that don't look too human-like, so this is nice. Anyway, let's actually get into a game, shall we? Alright, and here we are in a game. River City, I believe, is the mapper, and we're playing Assault, which means our goal is to either take out all the enemy mechs or capture their base. So capturing bases is going to probably be my job as a light mech pilot. But then again, Assault is a little bit different to other game modes. There's only one base to capture, so it's a little bit trickier to capture because they're more likely to be able to easily defend it. So here we go. It looks like a couple of light mechs. Myself and this fellow here. Man, we got to go out and scout a little bit. So this is probably, this is the most interesting and the most dangerous part of the game. Because the light mechs, yeah, we got to scurry out there on our own and potentially get ganked as a result. But if you're sneaky and, you know, you conceal yourself well and you're fast, you can do really well both in points and XP from like getting spotting bonuses and shit. And also just finding bigger mechs on their own and taking them out. Either just sneaking up on them and so they never find you, ever. or just circling them. See, I've probably gone too far. I keep whacking into trees. That's probably not good for business. Okay, I'm feeling, oh, there we go. Target acquired. There's someone. I've lost the target now. Okay, I'm fairly safe because, here we go. What's all this now? Okay, looks like they haven't got line of sight on me, so we're safe. I found some teammates. Okay, looks like he's laying into it. If we can find a sneaky way around, that'd be fantastic. Oh, there we go. Looks like we got some lag, which is, that's not great. Usually it runs pretty well. We don't have a lot of lag on the servers, but you know, occasionally it does happen. Spotting assist, there we go. Oh, can we get a shot? There we go. Oh, I've taken a little bit of a hit. I'm going to get out of the way here. Maybe come around the back if I can. It's a Centurion, so that's either a heavy or an assault, but I'm not sure. There we go. guys, don't shoot your teammate. All right. Looks like we took him out, right? Yep, that looks like that's what we did. That's pretty cool. So what I was saying before, the hollow triangles, we're only seeing full ones at the moment. Hollow means that there's no teammates targeting them. So if you can target a hollow one and someone can get a shot off on them, I feel like that's very valuable. There we go. I've just gotten a scouting bonus for scouting some, I presume, scouting some unknown targets.
New target acquired.
So if I can be sneaky and like just get some target locks on these guys for my teammates so they can lob missiles at them, I'm actually being useful for my team.
New target acquired.
And if I can not get hit while I'm doing it, that's even better.
New target acquired.
There we go. I keep getting
new target
assist
acquired.
Bonuses. Or not scouting bonuses, which is fantastic.
New target.
There
acquired.
We go. Let's just make sure that they've all, oh, that's a Shadow Cat. He should be easily taken down. He's only a medium mech, so hopefully someone's shooting at him. Yeah, maybe. I'd really love to get in there and just sort of sneak around and cause some trouble behind their back, but I feel like this is probably the best course of action at the moment.
Target acquired.
Oh man, can I even see him to like get a sneaky shot off? I don't think I can. You can zoom in. With middle mouse button. Okay, looks like they've moved away. Oh, hang on.
New target acquired.
Is that the same mech? There we go. I might not have the range here, but I feel like that's someone I can deal with. If I can just get him on his own. Get him on his own. That's what I meant to say. Get him on his own. Now that just sounds weird the more I say it. I don't want to go too far though. I understand this might be, this might not be the most interesting thing to watch. And this is actually a slower game as a result because it really depends on the map and how well you know it. I do not know this map very well. I'm still learning a lot of the maps, but if we were on like Verdant Bog, I think it's called. For example, okay, I need to get out of here. Someone's shooting at me. If I was on Verdant Bog, then yeah, I could duck and weave and do some real fancy maneuvers and be really, really interesting. But sadly, I'm not too familiar with this map.
New target acquired.
Okay, I think this is a little dangerous here. So if I can just move around, you know what? Maybe I need to go back around my team, around the other side, and see if I can flank them from the other side. But this is fantastic. You know, we've got these options. And there is friendly fire. You do get, I'm pretty sure you do get marked down at the end of the match for shooting your teammates. But you also don't want to get in the way of enemy fire. Here we go. Here we go. What's that? It's probably a big guy that I don't want to necessarily deal with ever. So just hide behind the buildings. And when you got a missile lock, here we go. Here we go. How are we doing there? He doesn't know I'm there. He's taking so much damage, I think. Or he's just taking fire from all sides. So I can slip in here and get some cheeky damage on him. There we go. He's taking a lot of damage. Oh, I love it. These guys are just ramming into him. This is a mess. This is just, I don't even know if I'd be hitting a teammate here or what.
Target destroyed.
There we go. That's a dire wolf down. Okay. Oh, that's someone. And I want to keep moving. I feel like that's the key, probably for just in general, but more so for the light mechs. You want to keep moving. So if there's a skill that you want to practice here, it's definitely moving while shooting. It's being able to keep your arms and your torso steady, just basically your aim steady while you're moving around. Now hopefully this isn't going to cause me to like basically find myself in the hornet's nest, so to speak. But I'm heading towards their base now. If we stop just a little bit. Okay, we're sort of winning. We've only got one death on our team. Three, I think it was, on the enemy team. But if I can get to their... No, this way. If I can get to their base and start capping it. Here we go. Hopefully, there's no one... Okay. Is there anyone protecting it? I don't think so, but they will be alerted to the fact that I'm trying to capture it, so I want to make a speedy getaway if I have to.
Acquired. Base is being captured. Enemy base.
All right. He's coming for me, so I'm going to get out of here before he gets here. That's a stalker. He's fairly damaged, though. Base under attack. That's our base. Oh man, what do I do here? Do I continue assaulting their base or what? If that stalker comes over here. Oh fuck. Okay. That wasn't good. That's yeah, that was a bad move on my part. I should have expected they were coming for me. Didn't even see them, fuckers. Okay, see if I can get out of here. With my hide intact. Cause I definitely don't want to be taking on more than one mech. Not a light mech. Looks like I might have gotten away here. I'm just going to concern myself with saving my own hide here. Don't be the hero. Okay, I think I'm actually out of the woods here. And by out of the woods, I mean in the literal woods, but I'm out of danger. We'll just go back the way we came. I think this is the way we came. Across the water here, and we'll try and find some juicy targets while hanging around and being protected by our teammates. So you may notice there's a little arrow on the ground. I imagine anyone who's a pro at this game, well, for one, I gotta wonder why pros are watching this video. I mean, you're welcome to. I'm just like, what? Yeah, I'm sure any pros watching this would be like, oh, look at this scrub. You know, he's still got the guide thing on the ground. Yes, I do. Because I'm still just getting used to the feel of moving in one direction while looking in another direction. But yeah, that's just to help me there if you're wondering. Hey, I just got a kill assist. So that means that I've done supposedly a significant amount of damage to someone. And they've just been killed by someone else, so I get a nice, juicy kill assist bonus there. So in the lighter mechs, probably mediums included, you probably don't want to bet on getting straight up kills on your own. So instead, you'll be going for the assist. Looks like there's some action over there. Look at this adorable stubby big old guy. Okay, all right. This is probably not a good place to be because I'm like a sitting duck, but I'll have a look around here just to see if I can get any juicy shots. What's that? That's a Stormcrow moving to cap. Okay. All right. Looks like they're advancing here. So if I can just be annoying and just help out anyone I can. Alright, this stalker is almost done. So if I can just get a shot on him without exposing myself too much. Alright, looks like he's down. That's good. Do I want to follow that guy there?
Enemy base is being captured.
It's tempted. Okay, someone is attacking the enemy base. Oh, beautiful. Perfect. Opportunity right there. I think I might have to get out of here though, because there's a guy moving around to possibly flank me. So I'm gonna take another route. Looks like the enemy base is in fact being captured to a sufficient amount. Oh shit! Okay, nope. I'm just getting straight out of here. We'll find another route. Okay, back this way. I would like to help out with the capturing of the base, because that does seem like something I should be doing in a light mech. I should be less concerned with laying in the damage and more concerned with just helping with the base capture.
Enemy base is being captured.
Okay.
Target destroyed.
As long as I don't run afoul. Oh, there we go. Got another kill assist. As long as I don't run afoul of any enemy mechs here, we should be fine. But ultimately, it seems like I'm on a good team. They are working together to capture the base. A lot of other teams are just like, oh, big old mechs with guns. Let's just pick the biggest ones and go in and kill each other and then we lose. Which is not great. I haven't got jump jets on this mech, so my mobility isn't the best. Like, I could just jump up to there, conceivably, but not here. So I'll vulture back at their base. Again, I don't want to, like, find myself in the middle of a nest of mechs, if I can help it. Okay. What's going on here? I've got a buddy coming after. All right, here we go. All right, I'll just try and get behind them if I can. There we go. Oh, try not to run into things. Oh, shit. All right. I think it's 2 against 1 here in my favor, but still, it's sort of, okay, that's the wrong end. Oh shit, I am in a bad way, but so is he. If I can just get a lucky shot here.
Enemy base is being captured.
Oh man, okay. All right. This can be done. Just don't want to hit my buddy here.
Target destroyed.
There we go. And we got someone else joining the party. Oh shit. Move out of the way. Back behind him. Oh shit, a bit of lag. That's not right. Move. Okay, alright. Here we go. Where is he? Where's the bastard? There he is. Oh, he's staying out of sight too. Fuck. Did we win? That's time over, I think. Alright, how did I do? Oh shit, that's actually pretty good, guys. Damage done, 279, which again, using that rule, which I would like to reiterate, isn't necessarily, a good rule to follow. That's just what I've read. I think I got a 30-ton mech and I did 279. Damage, which isn't bad. I got 7 kill assists, 1 outright killing blow. I did have 2 team damage, which is not good. I'm actually not sure where I applied that. 6 spotting assists. I actually did, to my eyes, I did really well. I'm pretty proud of that. There you go, and we'll just exit the match here. And I survived to the end of the round, which is always a good sign. If you do die early, you can spectate your teammates, which is kind of cool. But there you go, guys. That's MechWarrior Online. Like I said, it's my current obsession and I love it. It's my wallpaper on my phone and it just always makes me want to play it. I love it. Love mechs. Thank you very much for watching. Taste the game. Don't forget to gently caress that like button. It needs love like everything does. Be excellent to each other and I'll see you next time. Roleplay Gamer, out.